Hello everyone. Today I'm going to present our work titled as Developing a Novel Hearing Aid Framework Using Machine Learning and a Model of the Impaired Cochlea. This work is done with my colleague from Macquarie University, National Acoustic Lab, as well as Google Research Australia. So I will just give a short introduction about this research work, and also in method I will discuss about overall view of the framework, stimulus and training characteristics, as well as in results section I will just present the loss values as well as model output, and I will wrap up my presentation in conclusion. So as you know, there is a demand to improve hearing aid strategies to fit the individual needs in challenging acoustic environment. So to this, we propose a hearing aid framework, which is mainly based on an advanced computational modeling of the inner ear, or CARFAC, that stands for cascade of asymmetric resonator with fast acting compression. And another important component of our framework is artificial neural network. So this is a overall view of our ANN CARFAC framework. So basically what we have been trying to do is we try to just make the output of the impaired CARFAC as much as possible close to the output of the normal CARFAC. And how I simulated normal CARFAC and impaired CARFAC through the variable called OSC health in CARFAC model, and setting this variable to all to one for all channels, I could simulate the normal CARFAC, and also setting to the 0.9, I could simulate impaired CARFAC. So basically the tone is applied as input to the normal CARFAC, then the output of the CARFAC gonna be the NAPS or neural activity patterns, and then a smoothed NAPS is used to compute loss function. And from another side of the framework, again the tone, but this time the tone is applied to the ANN, and output of the ANN is used as input to the impaired CARFAC, and again a smoothed NAPS is used to compute loss function. And in order to compute the loss in this study, we use a structural similarity index, and loss values are computed by this equation, 1 minus SSIM of a smoothed corresponding a smoothed NAPS. So the tone parameters used in this study, in fact, they have 200 millisecond duration, frequency of 1050 hertz, as well as the sample rate of 22050 hertz, and the level of the tone is normalized to the CARFAC level. So the only trainable component of this framework is artificial neural network part. So a single dense layer with 4,400 nodes equal to the length of the input is used in this study, and the parameter of the ANN is optimized through canonical stochastic gradient descent optimizer with the learning rate of 1 and momentum of 0.9. So and train and validation subsets are basically 10 different random levels. So as you can see, in this study, we could show that both train and validation loss values could converge, and approximately around epoch 60, the model is somehow saturated in terms of decreasing the loss values. So in order to have a better understanding about what the model performing, so I took the model output in terms of the smoothed NAPS from the normal CARFAC as well as the impaired CARFAC. So the left plot is the smoothed NAPS of a validation sample, as I said again, generated from normal CARFAC, which is definitely the true smoothed NAPS, and the middle one is the predicted NAPS generated after epoch 1, and the right one is the predicted smoothed NAPS generated this times after epoch 60. So as we could expect, the smoothed NAPS generated after 60 number of epochs looks like more to the true NAPS as compared to the one that generated after only one epoch. So this is just another validation sample. Again, the predicted smoothed NAPS after 60 epochs definitely looks like more to the true smoothed NAPS, again as comparison with the one that is generated after epoch 1. So this is to confirm that after training, the model could generate smoothed NAPS that from impaired side that looks like more to the smoothed NAPS generated from normal part of the framework, which was desired. So in this slide, I show the input to the framework as well as the predicted in and output for two different chunks of the signal. For left side is the first 300 time sample points of the signal, and the right one is the another 300 sample time sample points extracted from somehow middle of the signal. As you can see, after epoch 1, the output of the ANN still doesn't look like that much as a tone. And when we move to the epoch 60, especially when looking at the middle part of the signal, we can see that the tone can be recovered. So, and this is another interesting result, especially when you look at the amplitude of the ANN output, that is almost as double as the input signal. So it shows that the ANN can definitely work as an amplifier and emulate the hearing aid in this framework, but definitely more work is needed to make ANN work as a gain compressor. So as a conclusion, we could show that the ANN could rectify the negative effects of the OHC decrease, and our ANN CARFAC framework has potential to be used for more complex acoustic scenarios, but definitely we need to work on the architecture of the neural network to make it more complicated, and we have to increase the batch size of the training using the GPUs and TPUs, and also we need to try different OHC health values. Thank you very much for your attention, and happy to take any questions.